Students protest in black mask against examinations. Many students from across the country are protesting against the upcoming NEET JEE exams, which are to be held amid COVID-19. Here we have another student coming up from Telangana State, Hyderabad, giving us details of why he is protesting against the examinations, and we will have a call with him directly right now in our show today. Hello. So, why are you protesting against the examinations? Can you please briefly explain us?
Yeah, madam, government is conducting JEE exams now, but we have no knowledge, no idea when they are going to conduct and how we are going to attend that examinations, in terms of transportation and in terms of accommodation and all. And meanwhile, in this COVID time, we are very much afraid, going into the examination hall, where a lot of people will be there. So, there might be chances of getting affected due to this corona.
Correct. So, and also, are you prepared for the examination, is the first question now?
Ma'am, we are prepared for the examination, but we are more often worried about how we are going to attend the examination.
So, if the government is trying to provide a proper transportation and everything, are you ready to provide? Are you ready to go for the examination?
Ma'am, if at all government is ready to provide all terms of transportation, accommodation, and all, we definitely to go. But whereas we are more afraid of this pandemic situation.
Okay, so. In this pandemic situation, what kind of demands you have on the protest?
It would be better, almost all we have waited for a long time, and if you could wait for some more time, that would be great.
Why? Actually, it is already a longer time. If the examination is not conducted now, it would also might drag an year end, which will actually gives out a loss to the students for an academic year. So how do you take that note?
Yeah, that's true, but we also need to think about our health and all, right? It is not only about examinations. If I get to write my examination next year, that would be fine. If I get affected, how the cases are going up. And it is not about only me, I'm gonna suffer or something. There might be a lot of students who may get affected due to that.
Okay, but don't you think it's a loss of an academic year? Yeah,
definitely, there's a loss of academic year. But ma'am, again, we need to think about our health and all, right?
Yes. So, when do you think exams would be conducted? Would be beneficial for the students then?
Ma'am, soon after, we get results of getting this COVID medicines and all, as we could see there's cases are getting decreases, as soon as after that, very next day, if at all they are planning to conduct examinations, we are happy with that.
So the vaccine, it might take a time till December to completely available to the hands of public in every area, every remote area. So then what do you think it would be an appropriate time to conduct the examinations in the month of December, which is at least 5 months after from day to day?
Ma'am, soon after the vaccination get delivered to people in remote areas, very next month, if at all they are planning to conduct exams, we are very much happy.
So, then how prepared are you for the examinations? I'm asking you once again. In this COVID-19 crisis, students might not have enough time to actually prepare for the examinations, and also lecture due to the shutdown,
that is again
colleges and institutions, teachers and the lecturers are also unable to provide a prop for lecturing and the guidance to the students as they confined to the homes. So now, how students are prepared through online classes for the entrance examinations?
So we are like, ma'am, if at all if government announces like a date, like as I said, like a very next month of December, if at all if, vaccination is given to the public in December, like very next month, if at all if they are conducting exams, we'll be having enough time to prepare ourselves.
Okay.
It is not correct that government all of a sudden telling that very next month like you will be conducting exams and you have to attend the examinations. As we also have need to get some time to get and we need to get some time to prepare ourselves. If at all if government says that tomorrow we are going to conduct examination, then there are a lot of people who have not prepared for the examination. So there are a lot of people who are at their hometowns far away from the institutions and all. So they are also supposed to come to city and they are also supposed to plan for the examinations and prepare for the examinations.
Okay. So then how are you planning to if in such a case the government is not taking back the decision on conduction of examinations, how will you be planning your transport and all?
I will be having no sources then. If at all the government is willing to plan for examinations as per them, they need not to write the exam, they need not to travel all the way from their native places, from their hometown and anywhere. So this is what students need to travel or students are suffering for that. So at least they are supposed to think from our end. It's not like that whenever they feel comfortable or whenever they feel like that it is time to conduct examinations and also we are ready to conduct. It is not about only them, no, ma'am. It is something like they are supposed to think from students end.
Okay.
We need government to look after all of us, like all of our issues and all. Need to understand like how the things going in today's time, like all these cases and all like is increasing day by day. So, taking care of all these things, government should prepare and government should think about all these things before conducting examinations and all.
Well, in the examination hall, which are going to appear shortly, if the government is not going to take back the decision in conducting the examination, if the government is not trying to hold on the examination rescheduling things, what kind of measures you expect the government at least to get implemented in the examination center?
Ma'am, there is no other option. If at all if government is planning or the government is willing to do whatever they are liking, so we'll be left with no other option. Either we have an option of either protesting or we'll be having an option of like getting in fear and going to examinations. Like mentally we'll be disturbed in fear of like corona and all, and in fear of like lack of preparation and all. And it will go completely wrong.
Okay, and then if the examination center is also taken care with the COVID centers and the COVID norms, which is already had government presented guidelines to the institutions and the centers. So, what kind of measures you expect at the center?
Ma'am, it is not only me who is going to write the exams, right? There are a number of people who will be attending examinations. It is not only about one or two. There will be any number of students who is going to attend examinations. So, till how much like the government are going to take precautions and all is will be like our question.
Okay.
And matter of like if at all examination centers are taking proper precautions like maintaining social distancing, it is good for saying. But when it comes to like practically, it is not possible. Like at our places, we could not properly take care of ourselves. Where, if at all, there will be n number of students attending their classes. There will be at least hundreds of students will be attending their examination in one hall. So, how much social distancing they could maintain and how much precautions they could take will be our question. If at all, government is taking action on this thing. like we are happy to attend classes, but from our end also we have some concerns, we have some issues, like government should be answerable for all these things.
Well, if you have protest, which now each and every state the students are getting on to the government decision, against the government decision this time for the conduction of NEET and the medical examination this time. So if the protest is not gone successful, what the students next step would be?
We are left with no option then. Whatever okay. Government is willing to do, they'll do, and whatever we could do,
So are you ready to go and write the examinations then, if the scenario doesn't work? If the protest scenario and the plagiarism didn't work?
Definitely we have to attend, ma'am. If we don't attend the examination, we'll be getting backlogs. They simply will mark our absent in our mark sheets and all. Definitely we are going to, anyhow we have wasted a lot of our time due to this pandemic time. Due to this corona and all, again we have to suffer for this backlog and all, again we have to wait for one long year.
Okay, it is eligibility come entrance test would put the lives of the student at a great risk of infection, is that you say?
Definitely, ma'am. Definitely. It is if government is willing to do as per whatever they like, then it is up to them. We cannot force government to, or we cannot tell government to not to do this or not to do that. It is up to them, whatever they're willing to do, they'll definitely do. And it comes to if they announce it, definitely we have to go in at our right examination, whether we are prepared or not, whether we are comfortable or not. They even have to look after all this, they even have to think of after all these things. It is not only government who can decide our futures, right, ma'am? It is not only government going to think about our health and all. If they say we are taking proper precautions and all, and we are properly taking care of each and every examination hall with proper, social distancing or maintaining each and every thing.
So how are you going to plan the transportation then?
Ma'am, as of now, we have no clue what we are going to do or what government is going to do. There are some people who are in good place, where they can find transportation. There are so many people, they are in their hometowns in rural areas, where they cannot find transportation. So how they gonna manage is again a question. For some people it is easy to reach to the examination hall. Some people, they are very far from their place. So all these things, we request government to think over all these things and decide whatever they are willing to do.
Okay, well, thank you so much, Arvind, for joining us on our show and sharing your concerns about the conduction of examinations in a short while. Well, according to you, from your end, I would like to present to the government that the students who are living in a remote areas, who are in a state where they couldn't afford to private transportation in the times of COVID crisis, lockdown, where they